In the previous video, we used lines as a guidance to derive tests. And we used IntelliJ's code coverage tool to tell us how much we had coverage in terms of lines. With our first test, for example, we were able to cover 90% of all the lines in the class. And we saw that actually trying to cover all the lines makes sense. We were able to even find a bug while doing it. Let's just formalize this idea a little bit. To calculate line coverage, we divide the total number of lines that were exercised by at least one test by the total number of lines of code in that class, or method, or whatever other unit we are trying to measure line coverage. But the best part is that lines are not the only criterion we can use. There are others. And actually, if you think about it, lines might not even be a totally good one. First, it can depend on how developers write their code. For example, the same code can have 10 lines or 6 lines if we put the ifs in a single line. It really depends on the developer. And of course, it completely changes the final outcome of our formula. If we don't test a line, we may have 9 divided by 10, which is 90% line coverage for the code with 10 lines of code, and 5 divided by 6, which is 83% for the code with 6 lines. It seems that having more lines is better. Okay, don't ever think like this again. That is why some tools offer not only line coverage, but also statement coverage, meaning counting the number of different statements, regardless of the number of lines the developer uses to write them. Some other tools even show instruction coverage, as they do it at bytecode level. For example, this is the code coverage report of a tool called Jacoco. If we zoom in, we see that it has missed instructions. Our blackjack program has 24 instructions at bytecode level, and our tests cover them all. Good. Research and empirical experience actually show that when testers only do black box testing, or in other words, when they test without using the source code as inspiration, they only achieve 60 to 75% coverage. So we should also think about structural tests when testing our systems. But you probably feel that although we have 100% line coverage, our tests are not enough. Right now, we only test if both players have more than 21, and if the left player wins. What about the right player? What about if we have the same points? What about the boundaries? And you're definitely right in having these questions. In practice, there is no single technique that gives us 100% confidence that our systems are tested enough, unfortunately. That is why we should combine all the different techniques we learned so far and test as much as we can. In the next videos, we will explore other coverage criteria, and we can definitely do better than line and state coverage.